After a two-year hiatus, there's no denying Australia's cruising industry is back with a vengeance. With Queensland's newest port now complete, the Southeast is preparing to welcome world-first vessels into our waters, as well as a renowned cruise line making its first ever journey to Australia.
The magic of Disney heading down under.
You don't have to fly to Disneyland, it's here.
After sailing around the globe for 25 years, Disney Cruise Lines is making waves for fans in Australia.
They get to step into the stories that they know and love, from Disney, from Pixar, from Star Wars and even Marvel.
For the very first time, the Disney Wonder, an 11-deck ship, is setting sail from Brisbane, Melbourne, Sydney and Auckland, stopping in ports all around Australia, offering 2 to 6 night cruises from around $720.
Specialty dining restaurants where you have the characters at breakfast or characters at lunch, the Disney entertainment, the Disney art gallery.
Whether you're an adult or you're a child, it takes you back. It is that real escape.
Disney Cruises will berth here next year, with Brisbane's new passenger terminal now able to accommodate the world's largest cruise vessels, many of which will dock from October this year.
We're finally going to get these amazing ships from around the world. They are nothing like we've ever seen before.
The big ships like Cunard and Carnival, Holland America.
And with demand for cruising surpassing pre-pandemic levels of 2019, companies are capitalising, launching competitive pricing and all-inclusive deals.
P&O and the Princess, their cruises are probably starting around the 80 to 100 per person per day.
While cruises around Europe are around half the price of flying.
About $3,000 for the week, but that is all of our food, entertainment, very little extra to pay.
The grandparents can go to the adults only area, the children can go to the children's area during the day, the parents can go to the pool, and that's the great holiday.
Bridget O'Brien, Nine News.